Hello, Dissenters! My name is Italics, and I am here today back in Space Engineers for another workshop spotlight to show you. Today we're going to be talking about a creation by Death's Head. These are battle suits, and they are upside down, so let me write that for you. These are really cool looking. We've got some mechs here in Space Engineers. They are fully outfitted with drills, rocket launchers, and Gatling guns, and they've got some nice aesthetics to boot. To be specific, we have Death's Head Razor Rhino. So it's Battlesuit codename Razor Rhino, and there's a few in this line of Death's Head mechs and battle suits. Some cool pink and purple colors here. And since we have two, we're going to be able to destroy one, of course. So that's going to be really fun as well. Now let's look at some of the visual details first before we get into the cockpit and start flying around. Because what's even neater is the legs are actually articulated. So as you fly through the air, the legs will move. They're on axles through the torso. And we've also got some nice little rhino horns up on the top, so creative use of some of the other materials. Plenty of thrusters to get some good speed, even a light on the front so you can see where you're going in the darkness. Four Gatling turrets and two rocket launchers by the looks of things. Now the question is, how do you enter this mech? How do you get into the battle suit itself? I also just love the ridged armor of this front here. It just looks so cool. You actually go around to the back and you enter through the spine. There's a little gap here. If you walk right up to it, you can see it highlight like so. And now you're inside. First person view. We could use some sweet camera monitors. How cool would Space Engineers be if there were little monitor displays and cameras that you could create? That would be awesome. But we'll switch to third person view to make this go a little bit smoother. And I'll turn off the HUD to make it even nicer looking. Now, unfortunately, in making these mechs, there's a bit of a problem. Since they're so thin, like the ligaments on them, the way that they connect to the main body, it's easy to snap off the pieces. It's like a pristine toy right out of the box, a collector's edition. You don't want to break it, so you have to be kind of careful with it, you know? But this thing does get some pretty good speed, and the speed almost works against it, because like I said, those arms and legs and appendages will fly out of the air. See how it has that cool animation? Can you imagine just flying forward on like a planet over the air, just hovering with your little rocket boots? Let's fly up a little bit more, hold the space bar down, and when we stop and maybe reverse direction, watch the legs. They should kick out. Yes, check them out. They're moving right now. We don't want to go too fast because, like I said, they will break. But I do think it's interesting how they are articulated. You can see them kind of moving around. Now, we will break these things. Don't you worry. That's kind of the goal here. But let's see what this looks like from the front. All right, swinging the legs out. Kick them out from under us. Oh, coming to a stop. You can see those sparks flying, but how cool does that look? Throwing the legs out and using those feet thrusters to come to a stop. So with these weapons, you can do all sorts of things. Strafing runs on enemy mechs. Of course, the Gatling gun as ineffective as ever, and I'm also making myself super dizzy in there because both my legs. Yes, that's kind of the issue. Yes, I hit him with my leg. That was intentional. It was a flying kick. All right, I was trying to do that. So we're going to blast him with the rocket launchers instead and make this look a lot nicer. There we go. Blow all the pieces off of him. That is a really strong armored hull, wouldn't you say? Now let's switch over to our drill hands and see if we can get close enough to actually use them. There we go. Hi, how are you? Would you like a head massage? Ooh. Let's fly the other rhino, who seems to be made out of some kind of impenetrable material. But I bet I could lose my legs if I spun around too fast. I've tried to copy and paste to make more mechs as, like, target practice for us. But alas, it seems I was unable to copy anything below the chest. So instead, we will just have to make do with blowing up what we can. As I continue blowing up all of these robot torsos who are staring at me and offending me, I want to thank you guys very much for watching this brief little workshop spotlight. I'm going to try to make more of these in the future since they are pretty easy to make and there's so many awesome creations out there that I have never seen before, like giant battle suits and mechs who can fight in outer space. What else do you want besides mech fights in Space Engineers? Can you make a better mech than this? If so, let me know. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like on the videos that you enjoy. My name is Italics, and I will blow something up with more missiles next time.